posted that she was
going to say something awful.
So I know who were also at the party, and they all have the same similar symptoms.
Oh my God.
And they also posted the exact same day on a Tuesday, 3 days after the party. Eventually, some of those people went to their doctors. Their doctors told them they had the flu. They tested negative. They were sent home. They were not tested for the coronavirus. All of these people, including myself, were a little suspicious of what we had. So we ended up finding out there was a research study going on in Seattle called the Seattle Flu Study. And they had started testing for the coronavirus just a few weeks prior to us falling sick because of the outbreak of the virus here in Seattle. So we signed up to be volunteers. We got an at-home nasal swab test kit. And that's how myself, I got a call from them telling me that my sample tested positive. And as of a couple days ago, five other people from the party tested positive through the flu study. Two people tested positive at the doctor's office.
Well, and that is that you look great, you look fine. Your hope for those who get worried about this, that even after it began, it helps to be young like yourself, you can survive it. So I hope you continue to get your health back and everything strong. Elizabeth, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Elizabeth Snyder. By the way, we're talking about all of this as we're getting word from Hoboken, New Jersey, that the mayor there has just asked people to self-isolate. In other words, without an edict or order, advice, something very similar to what the New York mayor, Bill de Blasio, has urged, that that could be the next step, something that the governor of New York State disagrees with. We'll see. There comes that.
America is at war against an invisible enemy, and we will win. That's the urgent message coming from President Trump amid the rapidly developing coronavirus pandemic. There are a lot of new developments. Almost 6,000 Americans tested positive, and over 90 people here have died. Cases are now being reported in every state except West Virginia. And millions more across the country will be impacted by businesses and schools shutting down.
They're going to pop back like nobody's ever seen. One day we'll be standing possibly up here and we'll say, well, we won. And we're going to say that. As sure as you're sitting there, we're going to say that. And we're going to win. And I think we're going to win faster than people think.
The president also warned Americans to take precautions. It is also saying the country will get through this.
We're asking everyone to work at home if possible, postpone unnecessary travel, and limit social gatherings to no more than 10 people. We're stepping it up as much as we can, and the testing procedures are going well. We are looking to save the maximum number of lives. Everything else is going to come back. Our life is never going to come back. We have to get rid of this. We have to win this war, and ideally quickly. Because the longer it takes, it's not a good situation. But if people do what you're telling them to do, what we're asking them to do, you're going to see the saving of a lot of lives. All of a sudden, we're going to say, wow, that's looking good, that's looking good, that's looking good. And we're going to be on the other side of the curve. And that's a day that we look forward to.
Okay, so Dana Perino, who's just below me in the studio. Hi, Dana, how are you? What do you think about the president's tone today? He's got it, getting a lot of accolades for the full frontal assault on this virus, and I think bringing all hands on deck with regard to the stimulus package and warning Americans really take precautions, stay at home as much as possible.
I would rate it nothing short of excellent, because I think yesterday you saw the tone change, and you saw them spent a lot of time yesterday and today, a lot of time. Everybody, that team seems to be working very well together. And then you add that, so the